Welcome to Wintergatan Wednesdays. Today we are unboxing three of the most exciting packages in the whole process of building the Marble Machine X. And we are going to put the contents of these packages all into one sub-assembly. And I've been longing for this for such a long time. See what we have in this one. I ordered this 4 months ago. That was 4 months delivery time. This looks nice. So this is a custom made attachment chain that I have designed on a chain designer on the Tsubaki website. This is from Japan. It's so cool because they have this lightweight plastic PC version which reduces the weight of the chain. This looks incredible. So we have two sides of the chain. So here's one chain lock and here's the other. It should be like this. Wow, awesome. So here's one side of the chain, here's the other one. So these attachments are made to hold the contents of this package. And in here we have something even cooler. Wow, goosebumps. This is unbelievable. This is absolutely unbelievable. What about that? What do you think about this finish? So these bluer ones still have the protection paper on. And this is a clear, transparent one where the protection paper has been taken off. I'm gonna keep the protection paper on for as long as I can. Look at this. Oh, I'm so happy right now. So these acrylic marble carriers have been CNC'd again by Alex CNC. And Alex CNC has made a video specifically about the process of making these. And he's showing off some really interesting techniques, for example, flame polishing. I really recommend you to go and check out Alex CNC video on how he machined these masterpieces. It's amazing. In some light, I can look straight through them. I don't know how it looks in the camera. Yeah, you can see here how transparent they are. You can see my finger there through. This is not only a gimmick, because this conveyor belt, it's going to take up a large surface on the side of the Marble Machine X, and having these carriers transparent will make it much more lighter and airy. It was a kind of intimidating surface like this on the side of the machine, and thanks to Alex's work, this will now be so much more lighter and nicer. And I'm really happy about how stuck the marbles seem to be on there. I'm really shaking this now, but the marbles doesn't want to go anywhere. So we have the attachment chain and we have the marble carriers, and now we need some kind of sprockets that can drive this chain. For the sprockets, I reached out to another YouTube hero of mine, Disaltoni. Disaltoni made a video a while back covering the process of making these sprockets.
Between me and you, I'm getting a very Manhattan Project kind of a vibe. A few people scattered all over the globe, not talking to each other, working on small parts of a bigger machine no one fully understands except Martin himself. I assume when it's done in the hands of Martin, it should make beautiful music and or control the weather. Not totally sure which. At this point, you'd likely assume that I must now somehow get these parts to Martin. But if I got my timing right, and everything went according to plan, Martin should already have these parts. You see, I realize this might be hard to follow, I apologize, but this video that you're watching right now already happened. It happened in the past. Martin, if you ever get out of here, I need you to do me a favor. Up north, there's this big olive grove, you know it? You just can't miss it. It's on a big slope with a breathtaking view of the mountains in the distance. In that grove, in the shade of an old olive tree, you'll find a big red arrow that has no earthly business being there. There's something buried there I want you to have.
Zihuatanejo.
The Elder Wand, the Stone of Resurrection, the Invisibility Cloak. Combine the three of them and you have the most powerful wizard of all time. Should we make a little comparison to what I had before this? Sprockets. Carriers. So, before and after. And I have to read something to you. I had an email from Joseph, and it's actually Joseph's email that sparked the change from this to this. I'll never forget it because he used the word ugly duckling. Suggestion number one, your marble lifting, Shane. You, that is an ugly design. I will allow that artistically it may be a beautiful swan, but as an engineer, I assure you, it is an ugly duckling. Sorry to be so strong, but I suppose that you understand. I suspect that you have a strong emotional reaction to things you see in the world that others feel no emotions whatever. We are kindred spirits in that sense. When I see a great mechanical design, a laugh, a belly laugh. When I see a problematic mechanical design, my stomach retches and I can almost taste the bitterness in my throat. I believe you are forcing a chain designed to secure the gate of a chain link fence, this one, to do a job it should not be asked to do. This abomination should not go on your world tour with your beautiful MMX. What solution do I propose? Attachment chain. Really, check it out. Thanks, Joseph, because it's thanks to Joseph that I went from this to this. I hope this will give you a belly laugh and that we all can move past from this. I need to countersink each and every hole here. This is not purely aesthetical because the outer marble, this one, is actually gonna glide over this surface. So I want this screw to really sit flush with the attachment. That looks flush. This is designed to let one marble in like this and then to keep the second marbles out. And I, in the last minute, changed the geometry a little bit, and as you can see here, it's really tight. And if I push it, the marble goes in very lightly. And it's like a millimeter of the corners of the acrylics here. So I'm actually going to take this round sander and just ever so slightly grind off the corners. Just touching it. And that's what I need to do. And the marble goes in easy. Killing Alex, finish again. Let's see if I remove protection. The sanding away of the corner is actually not reducing the finish. So now I need to do that for the whole conveyor belt. Okay, let's check if the parts from this Ultoni fit. That looks nice. That sound is not good. The chain is climbing on the sprockets. So you hear that? Chuck that. Is it the wrong sprockets? This is not smooth. Look at that though. Wow, that looks cool. So the cool thing with these clutched bearings is that I can't pull the thing down. It can only move one direction, so I can only move it this direction, but this climbing is not good. Oh, here's the marbles falling off. Oh, that looked great. I'm gonna show you that later. That. Wow, that, this is the pierre de resistance. these bumps, boom, 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 I don't think we should have them. That works though. Okay, let me show you what I think is going on. Okay, I know what's going on now. So notice this sound. That sound. That sound is not good. I don't think it should sound like that. So here is what I think is the problem. So on the chain configurator on Tsubaki's website, all the chain links had this 8 shape, like this one I'm pointing at here. But you can see here, the plastic links didn't exist in that configurator, and all the links had this 8 shape. And as you can see here, this straight line, this is much higher exactly here. So basically this area didn't exist in the chain. And what we can see here is that this flange of the sprocket climbs on this white edge right there, then dips down. So here it clears exactly according to my drawing, but it climbs up here and the tooth are not engaging and the sprocket is not running correctly. Can you even see that? Oh, sorry, sprocket. Can you even see here that we have some black paint here on the sprocket? So let's try that again. I paint some ink on there. So we run over it like this, then we check. And yes, you can see some black paint on this flange. And that's what's producing the dunk 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 sound. So basically, I need to reduce the diameter of this flange to make the sprocket really ride. Here we see it very clearly, actually. For me to go in and alter parts from this Altone is like having to re-sculpt the David statue. How should I do it? So I need to remove 2 millimeters of the outer diameter of this. And since I really don't want to mess up the beautiful parts from this Altone, I'm gonna do it really, really carefully. Just kidding, of course. I will, of course, use the angle grinder. Just kidding, of course. And pray to the CNC gods for not ruining this Altone's work. Alex CNC helped me with this work holding concept and the tool path for cutting metal. My CNC machine is mostly designed for softer material, but with the correct tool paths and light cuts, it's doing a great job on steel. Okay, time to compare the sound with a smaller OD. That is great. It's actually very light to move it now when it's hanging correctly. Cool. So we take the second one, we put it in here. Wow. cultural tradition of building marble machines, the lifting of the marbles is one of the most important aspects. It's this play with gravity that makes marble machines so enticing. On the Marble Machine X, I have gone all the way to try to implement different kinds of marble lifting techniques. Again, this is a perfect example of where my lust for aesthetics on the Marble Machine X provides a lot of engineering complexity. On the real machine, the conveyor belt will not be driven by a continuous rotational movement. It will be driven by these two pistons, which means that the marbles will be lifted in increments in time with the music. So basically the marbles will be lifted, lift, 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 like that. Thanks so much to Alex CNC. Definitely go subscribe to his channel. And thanks to Dissol Tony, the pedagogic prodigy and professional pun maker. Your sprockets were awesome. My design had a flaw in it, but I could save the day. I also want to say a big thanks for the support for the Marble Machine X t-shirt that I made last week. A lot of you asked for posters, and I have been working on a poster actually. Here are the two first test prints, but I really want to get this poster perfect, so we will update you later once the poster design is ready to go. And if anyone didn't know, I'm trying to build the Marble Machine X, a music instrument that is supposed to be able to go on a world tour. For this I've learned some CADing, and I'm now assembling the 8,000 parts, and you can follow the progress of this project every week here on Vintergatan Wednesdays. I want to thank the Marble Machine X engineering team, and I want to thank everyone who are crowdfunding this project through Patreon or YouTube channel memberships, and I want to thank you so much for watching. Looking forward to see you on the next Vintergatan Wednesday.